Welcome to the Jill on Money Call of the Week. We're presented by Marcus by Goldman Sachs. If you want to get on the air with us, you have a question. It could be about retirement. It could be about paying off student loan debt. Maybe it's a refi question. Send us an email. All you have to do, ask Jill at jillonmoney.com. We'll get you on the air. You know, we may not respond immediately, but we're going to get you, okay? So this is Greg from Minnesota who has contacted us with, I think, really good questions. So, Greg, welcome to the program. What can we do for you?
Well, thanks for having me. Jill, I've got a situation where I'm 58. My wife is 49. We don't have any month-to-month debt. Our house is paid for, and we currently have between 1.5 and 1.75 million in savings and retirement accounts.
Great.
I've got two kids. One is in college, first year, and one is a junior in high school. Mm-hmm. We've got 529 accounts for both of them that will pay for roughly half to two-thirds of their undergraduate tuition. And I currently have two 20-year term life insurance policies, one for me, one for my wife. Those are in the amount of $500,000. Mm-hmm. They will expire in November of 2020.
Okay.
And my question is, should I let those policies expire? Should I renew them on an annual basis? Or should I get a new policy for, say, maybe a 10-year term?
Okay, let's go through a couple of other things. You guys both work?
Yes.
Do you get insurance through work?
Nominal insurance. My wife gets a nominal insurance policy. It's probably, I think, a $50,000.
Mm-hmm. And is there any way that you could buy more insurance through work, just out of curiosity?
Good question. I don't know the answer to that, but I'll have to investigate.
Yeah, let's check that out. I mean, look, you bought this thing 20 years ago because you were basically saying to yourselves, if we were both to drop dead, we have no money saved, and so we'd want this $500,000. Now, with $1.5 million saved and most of the college paid for, the need for life insurance has diminished dramatically. It really has. Now, that said, you're both working. How much do you guys make together?
It fluctuates between $150,000 and $175,000 per year. Mm-hmm. I'm a consultant and my income can vary from year to year.
Okay. I like it when it's more. No, just kidding. Of course, it's a joke. You know, you're doing a great job saving and investing. You're still putting money away. What kind of retirement account do you have for yourself?
We've got, my wife's got one through her work, mm-hmm. and we've got Vanguard, a series of Vanguard, you know, mutual funds.
Yeah. I mean, look, I don't want to make you crazy about this. The reality is you probably don't need this policy. But if you want to buy yourself a little bit more time to save even more, I mean, because really what you're saying is, if one of us were to die, right, what would happen to the other one? And so for you, is your income about similar? Like, does she make a lot less than you?
No, it's okay. Similar.
I mean, you have no debt. So let's play it out. If God forbid you drop dead tomorrow, could she pay the bills on her current salary? Not the college, just the bills themselves?
Yes.
Okay. And same thing for you, right?
Yes.
Okay. So now what we're really talking about is, whatever is left over for the surviving spouse, some of that money could be used to help finish off college. Or, you know, frankly, it may be that on one income, you might actually qualify for some federal loans for the kids themselves and, you know, to finish out school. Again, we're talking about worst case scenario. And you could preserve that $1.5 million or $1.7 million. And then, you know, the reality is that while the kids are in school, probably the surviving spouse wouldn't be putting a lot of money into savings, maybe would continue with a 401k. But at some point, you just don't need this insurance. If you could find a cheap term policy to give you guys a little bit of comfort, maybe to just get through, honestly, like the next 5 years for your, you know, your kids being kind of done, right? Sort of out mm-hmm. of the house and done. It's worth looking at. Is she more uptight about this than you?
Yes.
Because she's younger. And she's the mom. Yeah. You know, it's worth exploring. This is what I would do. Number one, let's find out if she can buy life insurance through her employer for you and for her. That's a possibility. Okay. Next, let's say you can't. Then I would hop on policygenius.com and I would just go see what it would cost, because maybe for peace of mind to have her be feeling like, okay, for the next 5 years or 10 years, we're covered. It costs a little bit of money, but it gives her peace of mind. Then it could be worth it. So let's see what those numbers are. Shoot me an email and let me know what they are. And let's make a determination whether or not it's really worth it. How's that sound?
That sounds great. I'll do that.
All right. Policygenius.com and then wife's employer. Let's see if you can buy some extra coverage. Okay.
Got it. Will do.
All right. Come back with your homework completed, please. All right. Thanks for calling. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Take care. Okay, that's the call of the week. If you have a financial question, just give us a holler. Send an email to askjill@jillonmoney.com or go to the website jillonmoney.com. You can click the Contact Us button right there. Oh, by the way, while you're there, sign up for our free newsletter. It's free. Why not? We drop new episodes of Jill on Money every Tuesday and Thursday, and you can download the show anywhere that you get your podcasts. Apple, Google Play, Radio.com, Stitcher, wherever. Our music is composed by Joel Goodman. Mark Talercio is our executive producer. We're distributed by Cadence 13, and our show is presented by Marcus by Goldman Sachs. See you next week.